Where does it say in the Deen? Because I've seen a lot of people using the name of Islam and trying to, you know,
ruqya
to people. Yeah, yeah. So what does it say in the Deen that jinns possess people?
النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام عمرو بن العاص was in the masjid and he came to النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام from a Taif. He said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, I cannot focus in my prayer." Prophet ﷺ named the jinn that it was in him. Then Prophet ﷺ said, "Lay down," and he put a chest and he said, "Get out, or the adu of Allah." He said, "Get out, or the adu of Allah." Prophet ﷺ addressing jinn. I tell you this one, yeah.
Yes,
I hear. But I tell you this funny. I met a brother last week. He said, "Akhi, I don't believe jinn possess no one." Okay. He said, "But what happened to my own brother? Changed my mind." I said, "What happened?" His brother Shavis Bush. He works in bagel bite. Let me even mention the bagel. If you want to check, go. He's a Tunisian brother. He said, "What happened to my brother? I couldn't believe it." I said, "You know what? What happened? Tell me." He was showing a video for his brother. He said, "Akhi, this is not normal. This is not normal. This is my brother sitting down. I'm just reading the Quran." Because someone put magic on him. He said, "The way my brother is moving his legs in the air, I know my brother very well, very well. That is not normal. He does that. Why the Quran is reading on him?" He said, "What I see, what happened to my brother, I change now. Jinn possess human being."
So I want to know the hadith that you've quoted.
Ah, yeah, the hadith of Amr. Sorry, sorry.
So you said it's sahih hadith.
Yeah, sahih hadith of Amr. Yeah.
So Rasulullah said, "Akhruj adu
Allah." Akhruj adu Allah. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, it's not the other one with the boy. There's another one. With
no, Amr ibn al-As one. Amr ibn al-As. Either is Amr or Abdullah ibn Amr al-As, who was leading the salat. He was imam in Taif, and he couldn't focus in prayer.
Okay, yeah. So, okay, cool. What does it say in the Quran that jinn possess people?
The verse that in the Quran Allah mentioned is that in Surah about the riba. That يتخبطه الجن.
That's talking about riba, though. It's not talking about
no, no, no. Allah has given the example that how a person involved in riba is like someone being possessed by a jinn. That's what the Quran says.
Well, when you're sinning, are you not possessed by a jinn, by shaitan?
No, no, brother, no, no.
Shaitan your body when
no,
you're
sinning,
right?
Why Allah specified the riba one? Allah's giving example. Do you know what Allah gives example?
Okay, riba is a sin.
No, no, but
the sin is done by shaitan.
The example Allah's given here is when the man that dies about riba, he will be resurrected like someone who is being possessed with a jinn. He's not speaking about if you do riba, you've been possessed by a jinn. No, he's speaking because people that do sins, some of them they'll be resurrected different than the other people. The person who is indulged in riba, he will be resurrected just like the person who's been possessed by a jinn. Do you understand that? So Quran mentioned that.
Okay, you know in the Quran, Allah talks about sihr a lot. You know.
I think I get out from there.
Sorry.
Brother, your camera is too high, man. We know that's all.
No, I
okay.
I
do you have Arabic one?
Yeah.
Hadith Amr Del 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 Uray Del. Hadith Amr. Amr ibn al-As. I don't know the hadith exactly for wording, but I'm going to put hadith al jinn. شعره أخي غير مسلم أصلاً شعره.
شعراوي.
شعر أفوسه شحرور. ده خبيث أخي. شعراوي لا تقول شعراوي سوري أخي. أفوسه شحرور.
لا شعراوي.
ها شعراوي أخي.
مو عادي بنوي.
يقول لي قلنا ما خش اسم بني آدم.
لا دي سوى النار.
لا تكري. لا تكري. That's why we call them بنوي. And بنوي رمز.
I have to Khalifu, where is it? Put a hadith on the jinn or something.
There's one hadith that talks about jinn possession. It's about a little boy that was possessed by a shaitan, I think. And then they bring it to the Prophet and the Prophet said, "Akhruj adu Allah." That one I've heard about, but not the one that he's talking about.
No, this one about Amr, Amr ibn al-As. Prophet started putting his, that's why when you do ruqya sometimes, you put your feet on the chest and you say, "Get out," or you hit. Say, "Get out, ya adu Allah."
But then the guy wasn't possessed though. Was he?
Did the jinn come out? What do you mean he's possessed?
But was he possessed or was he acting all possessed and stuff?
No, no, see, to be honest, I'm a person without ruqya. And I saw how people react. There was a sister that, of course, she was her brother. I done ruqya on her shoes and her knees. She was running faster than I ran on my legs. That is not normal. Is that normal?
Well, there's something called placebo effect where people believe something that's not there.
Example, so what I will see is not there.
I'll give an example.
No, brother, I saw with my own eyes. Our three brothers saw it.
Wallahi, I'm asking you general
questions. Okay, no problem.
And I've come here to learn. I'm not here to ask.
All right, you can, I'm trying to find
there, there's a guy, right? There's the one priest, right? I forgot his name. He used to be very famous in America. So people will come to him and he will kill them. So some there were people who could not walk, right? When they come to him and he says, in the name of Jesus, wake up, these people believe what this man is saying and they end up standing up and walking, right? But then when the guy leaves and they go back home, the pain slowly returns. That is called placebo effect. I've never seen someone with a jinn, someone who got possessed by a jinn who 100% gained a cure.
I saw it.
100%.
100%, leave it completely.
So he was mentally sick.
He was mental. There was a neighbor of my of ours. He never spoke French in his life. He has not French, brother. Next minute speaking French. Next minute, brother, next French
time,
is speaking.
Next time, make a video.
That's why, but brother, Allah. If I see it, people, if I show you a video, you're gonna believe it.
Yeah. Huh? We can play with the video.
We're gonna play with the video, akhi.
You know that?
There's no proof. What is known by, is ma'ruf, akhi. Yes, where you're coming from, you're coming from the angle, akhi, of respect, this atheism angle. They just try to, and I'm not saying you, they try to explain everything based upon material way. Because of this, I'm not talking about when I left. I saw with my own eyes, everyone see it, that this woman, she was running on her knees. No, she. I'm not talking about her. She said, I'm telling you what I saw. I didn't have the problem. You understand? The example you gave is a person believes something, then when the person goes, that was not happening to him. I'm talking what I saw, what the brother saw. One of the brother, when he saw that, he said, akhi, it's not normal. She's running on her knees, akhi.
What about when Hassan's finger stretched?
Not stretched, akhi. The finger became like this.
It became massive.
The brother's finger, akhi.
The finger
like that, akhi. It's unbelievable. And that sunnah in the beginning was known for a place of jinn. Because we do ruqya. Everyone's doing. The brother was doing ruqya on him, akhi, his finger became like this. That's not normal, akhi. Don't tell me. He's not him, he's saying that. I saw it. He was there. Brothers were
so
there.
His finger was normal.
It was normal. Recite the Quran. He was, so you can see something is moving. Because like, well, how you do it, if you grab him here, it's normal. But if you grab him this side, he starts shouting, the jinn is this side. Next minute, you grab him here, next minute, akhi, the finger is going like this. You know, some brothers, when they saw that, say, akhi, this is not normal. Akhi, if you see me, I saw my own eyes. I cannot deny it. And something which is observable, it's been people that they are jinn and been cured. One of the sisters, alhamdulillah, 100% gone. Alhamdulillah, left. But I don't get involved too much with this one. Akhi, this one, I don't know how exactly. Take my number. I can send it to you, Slav, inshallah. Because like I told you, 8 o'clock. And sometimes, the human go inside jinn as well. I'm joking, this doesn't matter. Because one brother said to me, I said, you know, you always do crazy stuff. He said, I think I have a jinn. I said, no, you are inside the jinn. No, you are. I mean, the jinn asking the imam to do ruqya on you, on them. 079. And you can send me stuff. I can send you stuff, inshallah. Where have you been?
I've been just taking break from
Speaker's Corner.
Yeah.
Mashallah. You're looking good, mashallah.
Alhamdulillah.
I'll speak to you soon, inshallah, because I have a class, a lecture in Markaz Sunnah at 8 p.m. But I have to go. But send me a WhatsApp, yeah?
Okay.
Inshallah, akhi. All right, assalamu alaikum, akhi.
Akhi,
Sheikh Sharaw, sorry. Sorry, sir.
Sheikh Sharaw, samahti, you